Unite second on the leaderboard with 5.27 million.
I don't play that many LAP tournaments. I usually just play one or two a year. The EPT final is the largest blind tournament I've ever played. I just try to do my best and, you know, not make big mistakes. It doesn't always work out that way for me just because I don't think I'm particularly good. I started playing chess when I was six. My mother decided it would be a good hobby for me to take up, exercise my brain or something. I started playing in tournaments when I was about nine or so. I was always pretty good, and I'm a chess master now. The very best chess players don't translate that well to poker, but the guys who are about my level or maybe even a little bit weaker in chess, lower-rated masters, tend to become pretty good poker players, actually. You know, I haven't had a good track record in live tournaments, and if I could win this, that would, you know, there's a lot of cash that goes with it, and, you know, my name would become known, so that's would be pretty cool.
Poker and chess are incredibly different. Do you know how hard it is to suck out at chess? It's nearly impossible.
Action is on Eugene Unite. He's picked up pocket eights under the gun plus one, and he's raising it to 200,000. Again, the min raise. Lenvi gets out of the way. Maceris with ace queen. And he makes the call in position.
I'm a little surprised there was no three bet.
Family Up gives up the button. Frazier folds the small blind. Jack's in the big blind for Brinkman.
Brinkman's got 15 big blinds. He's not likely to see a better hand than this.
I'm all in.
He shoves.
1.5 milski. So it's back on Eugene, who may be second in chips, but most of the time in this spot, I think he'd be lucky to be racing. This bet is for over a quarter of his stack. We know how tight Brinkman's been playing. I'd also be a little worried about Juan Maceras still to act behind. I'm pretty sure this is a fold.
Eugene giving it some thought.
Uh-oh.
And he's decided to make the call.
I think Juan's surprised.
I was calling him.
Juan folds the ace queen.
Ace queen.
You have? I have eights.
That's Brinkman's girlfriend, reality TV show star Natalie Hoff.
Brinkman is the 4-1 favorite to more than double up, and he just motioned to Natalie that if he loses this pot, he's breaking up with her. Eugene Unite says he's not the most experienced Hold'em player. Story checks out.
The flop is King 7-7.
Jack's holding up nicely so far. Eugene's got no backdoor draws. Means he can hit only an 8. Natalie's laughing.
The turn is a queen. That's Juan Maceras' card.
Too soon.
He would need to hit an 8.
Still looking for that 8.
The river is another queen, so Torsten Brinkman's jacks hold.
Torsten and Natalie get to stay together.
Your knight's taking it well. Whereas Maceras is having a bit of a sulk because he would have rivered a full house.
Ooh, too soon.
Thank you very much.
3.5.
Brinkman now has 3.3 million. But Ivan Freitas still has a commanding lead over the rest of the final table with nearly 6 million in chips. Thomas Lenvi, on the other hand, is in the danger zone. He's down to 9 big blinds.
He's got his jacket on and everything, like he's ready to go at any moment.
Well, he's folded, as has Juan Maceras. Queen 9 for Daniel Yuck. He passes. Ivan Freitas has ace 8 offsuit.
Better than the hands Freitas usually raises, but he might not want to get shoved on by a short stack Alex Gomez in the small blind.
It's been folded to Gomez. He has 8-7 of spades. Oh, yeah. And he shoves.
Call.
Unite snap calls him with tens.
And things are not looking good for us crowning Alexander Gomez with the third ever triple crown. He's going to need a lot of help from the board.
Just 19% equity, a 19% chance of survival.
This is what happens when you get short.
the flop. It's king, 5-3, all clubs.
Really bad flop for Alexander. Not only does he need runner-runner, but neither one can be a club.
Well, he hits an 8 on the turn.
But I've got some bad news for Alexander. He can't know this, but both the 7 and the 8 of diamonds were folded pre-flop, so he has only one out left in the deck. And if he doesn't hit it, he's going back to Brazil with a boring old double crown.
It's got to be the 7 of hearts, or we lose Alex Gomez. He will be our 7th place finisher, €185,000, but no EPT title for Alex, no triple crown.
Alex Gomez played very well, and I wouldn't be at all surprised if he ended up with that triple crown sooner rather than later. And Eugene Unite has closed the gap between him and Ivan Freitas to less than a million chips.
Alex, if you had won here, you would be only the 3rd person in the world to get the triple crown. So how disappointed are you there?
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed, but there will be another EPT, so I'm pretty sure I can make it. I did my best. I didn't have any spots at the final table. I was kind of short stack, but it's okay. It's poker. Ready for another one.
But now you're standing here. Who do you think could take down this grand final?
I'm a really good friend of Juan.
Okay.
And
he's got some following here.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you going to stick around and watch?
Yeah. I'll take a look. Why not?
Excellent. Well, Alex, it's always a pleasure. Congratulations on 7.
Thank you so much.
How much we have?
Juan Massera eyeing the short stack in the small blind.
He wants to see what the damage will be if the short stack shoves out of the big blind.
He raises under the gun with ace 10 of spades, makes it 230,000. Folded by Danielyuk and Freitas. Torsten Brinkman has 9-7 of clubs. I imagine they'll go in the muck.
He hasn't mucked him yet. Looks like Brinkman might be cooking something up here.
Wow. This is Brinkman trading on his tight image. He 3-bets light to 510,000, putting the pressure on Tamás Lenvay, but the Hungarian has woken up with a hand.
Even though it's been raised and re-raised, I just don't see how you get away from this.
Oh, he folds!
Oh, that's how.
Would have been nice, because I had the ace-jack. I had the ace-jack.
Ace-jack? Yeah.
Massaris doesn't believe him.
I can barely believe it either. Torsten Brinkman had a very good read on that situation and used his image to take that one down without a flop.
So with that pot, Torsten is now sitting comfortably in 3rd place. Over the course of the next 25 hands, Tamás Lenvay is off the bottom spot with over 3 million chips. Ivan Freitas continues to lead the pack while Juan Maceras has slipped into the danger zone.
Blinds are now 60 and 120,000 with a 15,000 ante. And action is on the chip leader, Ivan Freitas. He's got nines. And he raises under the gun to 245,000. A decision for Torsten Brinkman.
Freitas really hasn't gotten out of line too much today.
The decision is to fold. Fives for Eugene Unite.
Eugene's got about 25 big blinds behind. Not a lot of players are going to call and try to set mine with a stack like this, so this might be fold or all-in territory.
I'm all in.
It's the latter. All his chips go across the line.
Freitas will have a decision to make, but he's got a couple of players to act before him.
Lenvay gives up the button. And both blinds quickly muck.
Back to Freitas.
Counting out the chips for the call.
Freitas hasn't folded too often in these spots.
There's his wife. They're celebrating their wedding anniversary today.
I call.
He puts Unite at risk.
No.
Back a 5, back a 9.
Unite looking to spike a 2-outer. Freitas is the 4-1 favorite to bust Eugene and become an even bigger chip leader.
There's PCA final tablist Bolivar Palacios.
And behind him, Humberto Brenes.
A lot of support for Ivan Freitas. A flop of 10, queen, 6. Unite still drawing to a 5.
Umberto somehow found his way up to the wives section.
Ace on the turn.
United still dead to a five. Meanwhile, every poker fan in Latin America is somehow here and on their feet. United is down to one card, two outs, or it's checkmate for the chess master.
The river is a six. Freitas consolidates his chip lead. A disappointing result for Eugene Unite. Sixth place will earn him €250,000. Can anyone stop the freight train?
Welcome back to the European Poker Tour Grand Final here at the Casino Grand Madrid. Before the break, Eugene Unite have been in the thick of all the action. First of all, taking out Andrew Lee in eighth place. And then dashing Alex Gomez's Triple Crown dreams by sending him to the rail in seventh.
I'm on him.
Unite's aggression caught up with him, though, when chip leader Ivan Freitas called his three-bet shove with a dominating overpair. The board brought no help for the triple draw specialist, and he leaves us in sixth. It's not the first time these two have tangled. In fact, a key hand between them yesterday saw Freitas transform his chip advantage into a mighty lead and cause a whole lot of controversy in doing so.
Everybody's really upset at him. Everybody else is like, oh, this guy's unbelievable.
It's a really specific situation. I don't know what to say about it, but I didn't like it, actually.
I called the bet on the flop. When the turn came five, it went check, check.
River card, six of spades.
On the river, I put out a kind of small to medium bet, and my opponent postured for a while.
Hey, raise.
And then he said, okay, raise. And he put out a call.
I'm sorry, call.
What?
He said raise. Thomas Krems has been called to the table.
Call.
You announced raise.
No, speak English.
Everybody in the table saw what happened and everybody understood what happened.
Wow, did you see that?
That was not a mistake.
The floor man came up and said, you know, this guy did this earlier in the tournament.
I think this is exactly the same situation. As
wow, Freitas has got previous for this.
It's exactly the same move you had enough. I should share this information with you, okay?
He wasn't against the rules, but he did some mistake to make some kind of confusion on his opponent.
I believe we're looking at an angle shoot here.
Made a mistake by calling because I had a pretty strong hand with king queen, but I can pretty easily fold because I know he has a full house from his tell.
He makes the call. Freitas shows the full house.
Yeah. No, I know. I heard about this before the tournament started.
So ugly.
Ugly. Move was so dirty. Feel like I need a shower.
Nobody liked it for sure. Yeah, but it's poker.
Here rooting for my friend Ivan Freitas from Venezuela. We're all here and I hope he takes it down for Latin America one time.
He's a really nice guy. He's a smiling guy, a happy guy. He deserves the final table because he plays a lot of events and he gets deep in some of those, and now it's maybe his time.
Apparently, Ivan Freitas has shot the same angle multiple times in multiple tournaments. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, still shame on you. It's just messed up, man.
Five-handed action begins at the final table.
Yeah. One day, I will wake up with a big hand. You're going to double me up, and I'm going to cross the table. I'm telling you right now.
Word.
Yeah. I'm not shoving light.
Ivan Freitas folds the king three. Ace king for Torsten Brinkmann.
Big slick.
A raise.
Raising from the button.
250.
Makes it 250,000.
And now we'll just get the obligatory Tomas Lenvi fold out of the way.
He's in the small blind with king six of clubs.
No shot.
He does pass. Juan Maceras. Three bets with Jack 10 of hearts.